your sunscreen be causing you to have a vitamin D deficiency? And what are the best sunscreens for the chairin? What should we be putting on the chairin? These are questions that need answers. And for that, I turn to board certified dermatologist, Dr. Diane Davis, who is also the founder of Sunblock Kids, which is a foundation that teaches kids all about good sun safety. Just wanted to hop in here really quickly and let you guys know that Dr. Davis is located in Dallas. I know you guys are always asking about where can you find a derm. So if you're in the Dallas area, I'll leave her info in the description box. You can check it out. I've been getting pushback about sunscreen for years until all of a sudden now it's cool to be talking about sunscreen, whatever, you know. Anywho, one of the biggest pushbacks that I get about people wearing sunscreen is that we supposed to be getting that vitamin D. I'm getting my vitamin D from the sun, this, that, and the third. Now, I always have my answer, which you will hear in the video, to people who say stuff like this. So we're gonna go ahead and let Dr. Diane Davis answer that question for us. But first off, let's talk about kids and sunscreen.
We get almost 70 to 80% of your sun exposure you get by the age of 18. Mm-hmm. So when I see patients who come in and, you know, they start to have like either these little sunspots or, you know, liver spots that our grandparents used to call them, or other, you know, signs of aging, I will say, well, some of this is from your years of sun exposure. And they will say, well, I really don't go outside. And I'm like, yes, but think about how much sun you've accumulated over your entire life. And think about how much sun you had before you were age 18, when we probably all started really putting on sunscreen. Mm-hmm. So when you have about 70% of that exposure before the age of 18, that's when it's like the most important to protect your skin is during the younger years, mm-hmm. because your skin is just still developing and it's under, you know, so much influence from the sun and the ozone and the free radicals and all the stuff that's floating in the air.
I have a huge chunk of my audience on here on YouTube that love mineral sunscreens, but what is best for children?
My take is the best sunscreen is going to be the one that you're going to use on a consistent daily basis. Mm-hmm. So I personally tend to like mineral sunscreen. A lot of people have sensitive skin, and I find most of my patients don't have a lot of reactions with mineral sunscreens compared to chemical sunscreens.
Yeah.
So I tend to recommend those more. However, I do have some favorite chemical sunscreens, you know, like Super Goop is one of my favorites. It's the Unseen, which I think, you know, a lot of people like.
Yeah.
So again, the best sunscreen is going to be the one that you're going to wear on a consistent daily basis. For the little ones, you know, ages 6 months and up is when you want to start putting sunscreen on. And I always, again, tell all of my families, you want an SPF that is 30 or higher, and you want to make sure you're looking for a broad spectrum sunscreen that's going to protect from UVA and UVB. Of course, it's getting into the warmer months, so if you're going outside or doing, you know, pool activities, sports activities, picnics, or what have you, then reapplying, you know, every couple of hours is also extremely important. A couple of brands that I think that are really good that do make sunscreens for younger kids. Blue Lizard is one that does make sunscreens that are for kids like 6 months and up, and it is a mineral sunscreen. It's kind of interesting because it has zinc oxide, which is an active ingredient in your mineral sunscreens, but it works very effectively, protects the baby's skin. And I think as it starts to get a little bit old, I think the bottle starts to turn a little bit color, so that way you know, okay, it's time to change the sunscreen.
Oh,
yeah,
wow.
It's like their bottles have like this color changing technology, so I think, you know, the families and the kids just kind of like that because it's fun too. So it's making sunscreen fun.
Oh.
Neutrogena also has a pure baby sunscreen. That's a purely mineral sunscreen, and that's an SPF 50. And I think that one is like $10, you know, off Amazon, Target, Walmart. So very easily accessible. Mm-hmm. But it's in a white and pink bottle. And that one is, again, purely mineral or purely physical. So goes on, protects. And I don't have a lot of families that complain about that particular brand either. Another brand that I like is by Elta MD, E-L-T-A, Elta MD. They have one called UV Pure. So it's a purely physical sunblock. It's not tinted, so it's definitely white, and it definitely takes a lot of elbow grease to rub in. Yeah. And so recently, my girlfriends and I, we went out of town, and we were in Cancun by the pool, and they were in the pool, and their skin was like already red, and I was looking, and I was like, oh my gosh, I was like, you guys need to put on sunscreen. So I literally like rubbed it was the Elton D UV Pure all over my skin. It got to the point to where I didn't even care because I couldn't get it rubbed in. So they were like, you need to put on sunscreen like you have on white stockings. So we made a reel on it. I put it on my Instagram page. Yes. I didn't care, but I was the one who didn't get burned. And right. I was getting in the pool. And so I was like, you know what? I'm on vacation. I'm relaxing. I don't care that my legs look like I have white stockings on. Like yeah. they're protected and I know I'm not going to get sunburned. Right. So sometimes, you know, when you're having those, you know, fun, you know, swimming and sports activities, I'm like, just put it on and go. You know, you're protecting your skin, which is important.
Somehow you still looked gorgeous with your white stuff.
Right. Yeah, like I still had fun. I had my hat on. Like yes. I didn't care. I was dancing by the pool. And I mean, you know, that's the nice thing. I think, you know, so many more people are getting into, you know, protecting their skin. We're having more conversations about sunscreen. So I'm like, look, particularly for my face, I like one that's going to blend in nicely. But, you know, honestly, from the neck down, I will just put it on. If it's not all the way rubbed in, it doesn't bother me that much because I just want to make sure I'm protecting my skin.
Right. I get a lot of pushback when it comes to talking about sunscreen and darker skin tones. And we could be here all day talking about all the excuses I get. You know,
right.
My hand's broken. I can't rub it in or I never go outside. I live in a cave. Like, there's just so many
Exactly.
But one I do get, and I've always told people when it comes to vitamin D, that there are so many healthier ways to get vitamin D without sitting out in the sun. But obviously, I'm not a doctor, so I wanted to have someone like you.
But you are the style and beauty doc. But you
right,
are the style
thank you.
And beauty doc.
But I wanted to have someone like you explain. Do sunscreens cause vitamin D deficiency?
It's very interesting because I've talked to a lot of my colleagues about this as well. And so I think sometimes vitamin D deficiency can be several things. I think sometimes geographically where you live, just like how we talked about Barbados, geographically, you might be at an altitude where you may not be getting as much sun exposure to get that vitamin D because we do have the sun that kind of converts several of our compounds into what gives us our vitamin D. And it starts by absorbing the sun from the skin. So I do think if you live in certain geographic areas, then potentially, you know, not getting enough sun exposure, could that potentially lead to a vitamin D deficiency? Yes. However, the American Academy of Dermatology has come out with a very broad statement that we still recommend that patients apply sunscreen because the benefits that you're going to get from sunscreen outweigh the risks that you can get from being exposed to the sun. Mm-hmm. So I always tell my patients that I want you to wear your sunscreen every day consistently, but there are many other ways that you can get your vitamin D. I think sometimes some of us are just inside a lot more, either because of work or the office. So sometimes you're just not getting enough, you know, sun exposure. So I don't know that it's necessarily the sunscreen that's causing the vitamin D deficiency, more so than just like your lifestyle and where you live or your hours that you go to work. Like some people sleep throughout the day and they work overnight. Mm-hmm. So I think there's just other variables that come into play. So I would never tell anyone, well, go, you know, because some people will say, well, I'll go outside for 10 minutes and then put on the sunscreen. Mm-hmm. Usually if you're going to go outside and then you're planning on like stay outside, you're probably going to forget to put the sunscreen on, you know? Right. So it's just better to put it on before you, you know, leave the house or walk outside the door. And yeah. I just, like you said, I tell a lot of my patients and viewers, you can get your vitamin D from a lot of rich foods, you know, seafood, you know, rich fortified vegetables. And I really do like, I mean, you get it from vitamin D supplementation. With everything that, well, with COVID that's going on, I've actually increased my vitamin D uptake because it has been shown to be protective. So I'm actually just now telling all of my patients, look, we're living in a pandemic. Get you some extra vitamin D supplementation, as well as just the recommended, you know, multivitamin that you take. And that will be sufficient. But I do not ask my patients to shy away from sunscreen because of that.
Black people in general, I feel like we're, you know, we lack that vitamin D in general, whether this is outside.
Right. And some of it's our melanin too. Right. Some of it's our melanin too. You're right.
And
yes.
I think that some people assume that their vitamin D is low, but it's like, girl, did you go to the doctor? What blood right. test did you take? Like, girl.
Right.
So I go to the doctor every year for my physical, and then, you know, I have my healthy woman every six months. And in my last physical, my doctor said, you know, you do have a vitamin D deficiency, which I can probably assume is diet and, you know, just,
you know, right.
bunkered in here.
Right, exactly.
But, and this is a story that I love to tell people. She didn't tell me to go out and sit in the sun. She gave me a prescription for a vitamin D, and it was super simple. One pill that I take once a week for 4 weeks.
Yeah.
And, you know, I'll go for my follow-up and, you know,
right.
that's it. No one had the conversation about go sit out in the sun.
Right, exactly.
Yeah.
Yes, we just find other ways to supplement it. So again, you know, whether it's through your diet or whether it's through supplements, you know, there's a lot of good ways to get the benefits that you need from vitamin D. And I don't necessarily like to take a lot of pills. So finally, you know, and I know some people may not like the gummy vitamins. I personally love the gummy vitamins. So I'm like, because it reminds me of just like a little gummy bear or something, like I'm more excited to take it. Right. So I just get my vitamin D supplementation that way, you know, and then I for me too, I think I was definitely low at one point when I checked mine. And I think some of it partially was just probably because of my diet, but you know, I just found supplementation and then I just kind of check mine routinely. And depending on what my patients come to see me for, I will definitely add vitamin D on to their blood work just so that I can assess it just in case, you know, again, if it is deficient, then we can easily replace it, you know, through supplementation.
And there you have it. Did you learn anything new today? Let me know in the comments below. I know y'all gonna let me know anyway, cause you know, I love that about y'all. Y'all just be speaking your mind in them comments. I love that. Listen, also, make sure that you follow me on social. The links will be in the description box. The links to some of the sunscreens that Dr. Diane Davis mentioned, along with any other pertinent information, will be in that description box as well. If you find yourself being like, oh my gosh, when's there gonna be another fashion video? I'm actually creating a whole separate channel. I will link it in the description box so you can subscribe. The videos will be coming out soon. I'm taking me a little break in August, maybe a lot of a break in August. And you know, once I come back, refreshed and all new, there will also be a fashion channel. I don't know how I'm gonna swing both of these things, but we'll find out together. And I'll see you in my next one. Bye guys.